in accounting finance. I'm Robert Patterson. I'm going to be your host today. We're going to be joined by two of our colleagues from ACCA who are going to debrief us about ACCA. This webinar is all about trying to answer your questions, so please feel free at any time. I can see your questions up on the screen here. I'll try to answer them as we go through the presentation. The presentation will be relatively brief because we want to leave lots of time for questions, and then we'll leave lots of time at the end for questions to satisfy all your curiosity points. And please feel free to challenge us. Ask us what's on your mind. This is an important decision for you to take and for us, so we want to make sure everybody's comfortable. Okay. So let me begin before I introduce my colleague Patricia from ACCA, tell you a little bit about the school. You'll see the presentation, if you were with us at the open day, is a little bit like what we did on the open day last week. So we're going to, if the shoe fits, we wear it. So here we go. So let me begin by telling you a little bit about the Warsaw University of Technology Business School. And I'll be brief. Okay. The first thing to say about the school is we've been around for 25 years. And we're part of the Polytechnica, so we're a Polish university, but we've had long-standing affiliations with foreign universities. Our founders were three very large and well-known global business schools who have worked with us for 25 years. But we're moving on. Besides the founders, we're partnering with other people. We have a partnering relationship with Central European University in Budapest. Hopefully it'll be around for a while. If the politics can get sorted out, and we hope it can be sorted out. We're also partnering with a very good university in Lithuania and Vilnius, the Baltic Management Institute, and we work with them and do exchange of our students and our teachers. And finally, in far off India, the Institute of Management in Goa is working with us, one of the highly ranked universities, many in India. There's an overview of our program, our portfolio, and our lead showcase, flagship, if I can call that, is the Executive MBA program. But what you see there is a lot of engagement with business courses. We are not an academic institution in the sense of looking at theory. We're well anchored in the world of business, and that shows in the businesses we deal with. We do a lot of corporate training, and I think that tells you a little bit about where we're coming from as a school, as a business school. That's the way it should be. Now, Patricia is with us, and she's going to tell you a little bit about ACCA. So my colleague is right here, and I'm going to pass the stage to Patricia. Here we go.
Witam serdecznie, dobry wieczór. Nazywam się Patrycja Rokicka, pracuję w biurze ACCA w Polsce, gdzie odpowiadam za wsparcie edukacyjne studentów organizacji. Za chwilę powiem Państwu więcej odnośnie możliwości zdobywania ACCA w ramach studiów w Szkole Biznesu Politechniki Warszawskiej. Natomiast zacznę od kilku słów o ACCA. ACCA może być rozumiane na wiele sposobów. Przede wszystkim jednak jest międzynarodowa kwalifikacja dla osób, które chcą specjalizować się w dziedzinie finansów, zarządzania finansami oraz rachunkowości. Jest rozpoznawalna na całym świecie, co oznacza, że bycie członkiem i studentem ACCA, posiadanie tych kwalifikacji jest na całym świecie rozpoznawane jako potwierdzenie top kwalifikacji do uprawniających, pozwalających na pracę w różnorodnych sektorach. Jest to też kwalifikacja praktyczna, ma przede wszystkim przygotowywać do codziennych wyzwań, jakie stoją przed finansistami, przed dyrektorami finansowymi, kierownikami, menadżerami zespołów odpowiadającymi za aspekty finansowe w firmach. Na całym świecie ponad 700 tysięcy osób jest związane z ACCA. Członkowie organizacji to osoby, które posiadają już tytuł ACCA, zdobyły wszystkie uprawnienia, zdały też wszystkie egzaminy, o nich za moment więcej. Studenci są to osoby, które są na drodze do zdobywania kwalifikacji. W Polsce takich osób jest ponad 5 tysięcy. Jak tutaj Państwo widzicie, studenci i członkowie ACCA reprezentują ponad 180 narodowości, żyją i przede wszystkim pracują na całym świecie. To pozwala się zorientować w skali organizacji, ale przede wszystkim w perspektywach, jakie stwarza kwalifikacja ACCA, w możliwościach rozwoju swojej kariery w wymiarze globalnym. Co należy zrobić, aby taką kwalifikację uzyskać? Przede wszystkim należy posiadać wiedzę, jak już wspomniałam, praktyczną, wiedzę potwierdzoną poprzez zdanie 14 egzaminów w tym momencie, a od września 2018 roku 13 egzaminów. Pierwszy etap to egzaminy Applied Knowledge i Applied Skills, czyli przechodzenie przez poszczególne działy związane z finansami. Podatki, audyt, raportowanie finansowe, zarządzanie finansami. Co ważne, w kontekście dzisiejszego spotkania, te egzaminy można zaliczyć na podstawie studiów podyplomowych Szkoły Biznesu Politechniki Warszawskiej, Postgraduate Studies in Accounting and Finance. Tym samym, wybierając te studia, zdobywacie Państwo nie tylko dyplom renomowanej szkoły, ale też znaczną część kwalifikacji ACCA. Studia są zbudowane w ten sposób, że pozwalają na swobodne, elastyczne wybranie swojej ścieżki kariery i ścieżki rozwoju, w zależności od sektora, w którym już Państwo pracujecie, czy też w zależności od branży, w której pragniecie się rozwijać na przyszłość. Studia możecie połączyć z dyplomem ACCA Diploma in Accounting and Business. Jest on przyznawany po zdaniu i zaliczeniu pierwszych 9 egzaminów, ale też można skorzystać do zdobycia tego dyplomu. Potrzebne jest zdanie 2 egzaminów. Więcej o tym oczywiście będziemy mówić w przyszłości. Teraz tylko flaguję, że taka możliwość istnieje. Oprócz rozpoczęcia kwalifikacji ACCA na studiach, można też ten etap potwierdzić oficjalnym certyfikatem ACCA. Można też oczywiście kontynuować drogę do pełnego członkostwa poprzez zdawanie egzaminów na etapie professional. Mój kolega Tomasz Misiak opowie Państwu za chwilkę o drugiej ścieżce związanej z dyplomem GBS. Tutaj widzicie Państwo, ten etap można zaliczyć właśnie na nach. Dlaczego warto między innymi być członkiem ACCA, zdobyć tą kwalifikację? Jakie twarde dane poprą te wnioski, że warto zainwestować swój czas i też środki finansowe w zdobycie kwalifikacji? Jest to ścieżka rozwoju, która owocuje pracą na najwyższych stanowiskach w firmach, nie tylko w sektorach finansowych, ale w zarządach firm w ogóle. Członkowie ACCA, mając takie kompetencje, takie doświadczenie, takie umiejętności praktyczne, de facto mogą swobodnie budować swoją ścieżkę kariery, decydować, w jakich firmach, dla jakich pracodawców pracują. Tutaj widzą Państwo, tak jak na poprzednim slajdzie, jak i tutaj, wyniki ankiety wśród członków ACCA na całym świecie. 1 na 10 osób pracuje w firmach, które są wysoko notowane w rankingach pracodawców, ale też oczywiście w firmach, które są notowane na światowych giełdach. Również i firmy bardzo popierają bycie studentem i członkiem ACCA. Ponad 7 tysięcy firm to akredytowani pracodawcy ACCA, którzy w swoją politykę mają wręcz wpisane wspieranie swoich pracowników w zdobywaniu tej kwalifikacji. Bardzo chętnie zatrudniają osoby, które są już studentem bądź członkiem ACCA. Bardzo też chętnie zatrudniają osoby, które taką ścieżkę chcą obrać. Jest to bardzo często wsparcie finansowe, wsparcie w postaci dodatkowych dni wolnych na naukę i egzaminy ACCA. A dlaczego? Po prostu pracodawcy wiedzą, że to zaowocuje w większej efektywności pracowników i większych zyskach samych firm. Ostatnia z twardych danych, wymierna, myślę, że dobrze podsumowuje też korzyści płynące z kwalifikacji ACCA. Widzicie Państwo tutaj wyniki Golden Recruitment Salary Survey. Jest to niezależne badanie wynagrodzeń w Polsce osób pracujących w finansach. I jest, ono pokazuje wyniki w zależności od tego, jaką kwalifikację, jakie doświadczenie, jaki dyplom posiada dana osoba. Widzimy też tutaj, że najwyższą medianę, jeżeli chodzi o zarobki brutto miesięczne w Polsce, daje właśnie ACCA i jest to 19,5 tysiąca złotych miesięcznie. Także to tyle z wymiernych efektów. Przede wszystkim oczywiście ważna jest wiedza, umiejętności, kompetencje. I przypominam, można zacząć je zdobywać właśnie w ramach studiów na Politechnice Warszawskiej w Szkole Biznesu. Ja ze swojej strony bardzo rekomenduję taką ścieżkę. Jesteśmy do Państwa dyspozycji, jeżeli chodzi o pytania. Tak jak wspomniałam, więcej o ACCA jeszcze i możliwości zdobycia na studiach tutaj dyplomu GBS opowie mój kolega Tomasz Misiak, a ja jeszcze w tym momencie oddaję głos Robertowi, który przedstawi szczegółowe informacje na temat studiowania. Bardzo dziękuję i oddaję głos i ekran Robertowi.
Thank you, Patricia, and thank you, Tomasz, for turning on the lights. You can see us better. So I'm going to spend a little time just trying to go over and explain the thinking and the behind the program, because it's an interesting program. It has a lot of different aspects to it, and it's important that we try to communicate to you and you work with us to make sure that we've designed it right. We've done some research on it. We hope we've got the right design. We'll see. You'll probably give us some feedback on. Okay. We signed a memorandum of agreement with ACCA in, it's about 6 months ago, so it's been a long road. And we're very much partnering with ACCA. We work together on this mutual project, and we find a rewarding partnership. I'm Robert Patterson. My role here is I'm one of the trainers, instructors, one of a team, and I'm kind of overseeing and the program as an impresario or coordinator, as they call it. That's one of my favorite humorous posters that I have at home. It tells you a little bit about where I'm coming from. As an accountant, I articled with Price Waterhouse in Toronto a long time ago, and back then I was just happy to get my CA degree and then get on to banking, where I spent most of my time using that knowledge in accountancy in the world of banking. But I've come back to it. That's what happens when you become mature. You get to find out and learn where the real interests lie. Tell you a bit about what we're trying to do, and most importantly, how we're designing it and the thinking behind it, because I think that's important for you to buy into that where you accept. The key thing that drives us is it's market needs driven. We've looked at a lot of very good research that ACCA has done. They've surveyed over 19,000 people worldwide from about 120 countries. So we tapped into that. It's called Next Generation. You can find it on the website some very interesting information. We also looked a lot at the Polish market and tried to figure out what was going on there to make sure we'd come up with something that was market-driven and would be commercial. Okay, it would be commercial. That's where we think you people are coming from out there. So let me just share some of the key findings. Here's an interesting finding from the ACCA survey. The value of a finance career in this world of artificial intelligence and pressure on jobs and IT and all the other things that are happening in the job market, 85% of the respondents saw finance and accounting as an experience that's going to likely be valuable in the future and carry them through many years into the future. So that's encouraging, I think, for people who are in accounting and finance. We're not going to get rid of those people very easily. Okay. So that's good news. The interesting thing is how people want to get ahead. One question: do you expect your career move to be internal or external? Here's an interesting thing. 39% said they would move internally in this survey, but almost twice, well, not quite twice, saw that they would be changing jobs. And no surprise there. It's called the gig economy. I think I read that the average number of jobs now in the United States for people's career is going to be 7 in a lifetime. So that says we've got to be prepared to move on, stay with our current employers, but at the right moment maybe find an opportunity to switch, and that tells us that having a qualification that's recognized by outsiders is going to be very important to people. Here's another interesting statistic. 67 versus 33% of the respondents in the survey wanted to move and advance with a career advance and as opposed to a lateral move. So vicious, and they want to challenge themselves. We're going to call that, you'll hear me talk about later on in the program, what we call an achievable stretch. It's hard, it's not easy, Everyone's going to work at it, but it can be done. Very important, I think, idea in our program. It's an achievable stretch. We're not going to kid ourselves or you that this is easy, but we also feel confident that it can be done. Okay. Interesting information on professional qualifications. Clearly, the best way to learn is on the job. So all your schooling, your theoretical schooling, is fine and dandy to start off with, but what the job market wants and what employers wants is hands-on experience, ability to get something done, and that's best done by doing it and being there and knowing the ropes. And the overwhelming way of learning from the survey was on-the-job learning. Having said that, looking at alternatives down the list, a nice tertiary or backstop that was getting a professional designation that was recognized in the job market and by internally with amongst peers. So on that basis, thinking about that survey and looking at what we saw was going on in Poland, we came up with a target candidate. Okay, this is our target candidate, and hopefully this describes you. If it doesn't describe you, you won't be a very good fit with this program. You won't be a good fit with this program. This has got to describe you. So this is a really important slide that's worth dwelling on. If I had you in the room here, I'd do a survey and ask how people, by raising hands, how accurate this is. So here we go. Let me just go through this. Target candidate, you're building a career in finance. You see accounting and finance as something you like to do. You see it's something that you're going to be doing in the future, and you want to see it as a career. It's not just a job, it's a career. Secondly, though, you're probably in your 30s, and you're very busy with your work and your family. Okay. In fact, you probably suffer from time poverty, and it's very difficult. You don't have time to go full time back to school. So any program that we come up with has got to be part time and somehow squeezed in to the available time that you do have. Okay. Mature, and by mature, you either got work experience or you got a good solid foundation in accounting finance, and you can build on that. And you're also demanding, and you see that while there's lots of knowledge to be learned, you're prepared to focus along with us on passing these exams, because our program is really all about passing exams. You're going to learn a lot about a lot of things that are theoretical and of interest to your field, whether it be financial management or financial reporting. But the key thing you're going to learn and master and prove it is that you're able to master these exams and pass them. That's where we're laser focused on that. I really want to emphasize that. And finally, you're somebody who's willing to invest in their future. You probably have a job now. You may be very comfortable at it, and you may be enjoying it, and you may be progressing along, but you're in your 30s and you're wondering what you'll be doing in 10, 15, 20 years, okay? Because it's going to be that long before you retire. Kind of a discouraging thought, so but don't let me discourage it. So you want to build a career and build momentum. As the ACCA survey suggests, you want to build a brand, a brand within your company and out on the street. So I hope those of you who are listening there that this is a reasonable, accurate profile of who you are and what your interests are. On the basis of that target candidate, we designed the program. Okay? So there it is. That's right out of the brochure. That's a rather complicated graph, and I'm going to simplify it in the next few slides. But just a few key features of it. So the thinking, it's part-time, okay? And we've chosen Friday and Saturday, which means you're going to have to work with your employer to get some time off. And we realize the alternatives, of course, could be Saturday, Sunday, but that will rob you of any free time. And it's probably going to be mission impossible not to have any free time. You need to catch your breath. So we think you can and should work with your employers, let them know what you're doing. It's probably something you negotiate and get Fridays off. So it's a full term Friday and Saturday. We're going to do it and get it done annual cycle. We don't think, from what the market tells us, that people want to drag this out for 2 or 3 years. So it's going to be very intense. You're going to take about a year out of your life. It's going to be compacted in about 9 to 10 months. And you're going to get it done, and you're going to walk out the other side with a diploma in your back pocket. These are achievable stretch goals. I used those words before. I'll talk about later, next few slides. The exams are challenging, but we've got a good teaching team, and we've got a methodology that we think can get you through. We've done a lot of work on what we call pass assurance, and we designed it into the program from scratch. Okay? We've got a number of layers of pass assurance that allow you to pick up any, if you drop the ball on tests or on exams, there's going to be a way that you can pick it up and do better next time so you get through at the end of the day. I've said this before, this is for practitioners. People are working in accounting and finance and want to boost their career prospects and job satisfaction. And finally, we think it's good value for money. It's an investment in the future. I don't have a slide that I can show you, but unfortunately we lost it, but I did show it on one of the articles that I think is posted on the website. Very high returns in Central Europe for education. It's some of the highest returns for investing in your education. Investing in human capital gives you a very good return in this part of the world. All right, this slide, and let me just talk a little bit about, and I want to simplify what was in the brochure, just to get a little bit more clarity. One of the other aspects about this program is there's lots of flexibility involved. You can choose as you go along how far you want to go, which direction you want to go, based upon your interests and how you're doing the program. So let me explain that for a moment. Okay, here we go. Let's start off with a core program. Okay, and this gets you a diploma from the Warsaw University of Technology Business School. Okay, it qualifies under the ministry, a Polish Ministry of Education for graduate studies. That means it's a minimum of 180 hours, which happens to be also the maximum, which we think you need to take to get through these three courses. We name them after the ACCA courses. You probably know what they are now. F5 is performance management, or the old-fashioned word is management accounting. F7 is financial reporting, or some people call it financial accounting. And F9 is my course, which everyone calls financial management, so there's no ambiguity there. In a nutshell, it's 180 hours over 12 weekends spread over 7 to 8 months. That slide is maybe a bit wrong. It's actually 8 months. You're going to have August off, but for the rest of the year, you're going to be pretty busy. You'll be able to catch your breath in courses and study, because it will require you to do some at-home study. Most of your learning will be on those 2 days where you're with us in a very intense learning environment. At the end of each weekend session, two-day session, you'll be writing a test. A 1.5 hour test, and you're going to immediately get feedback on how well you've absorbed the weekend's work. Okay, and we're going to use that as a way to establish some pass assurance. Okay, it's a Ministry of Education approved degree, so you get a degree from a Polish educational body. It's very important when you're looking at the alternatives, maybe doing this yourselves on a step-by-step basis, or maybe doing it with a third-party professional content provider. These people do not offer degrees. We do. Okay. Its cost is $10,500. Why is that amount? Because we've got to cover our costs. But we hope and we see it that it's competitive in the market compared to other programs that are out there. There are other programs like ours in other cities, and we think it's a market price. By the way, we have a financing facility from Citibank Hanlovi. The details are on the website, participants in the program can get financing for that cost. Okay. And finally, as we're saying, this is obvious, it's ACCA accreditation. So it's a recognized professional standard, recognized by universally in the market here in Poland and outside of Poland. I think you can take this piece of paper and go a long way with it. Well, a lot of people will do that and say, fine, that's just great. That'll give them what they want. But if they want to go further, they have some choices. Okay? They can take that diploma and put it on their wall, and it'll be, we think, a very good diploma and well-recognized within Poland. What else can I do? Well, here's some other options. Okay, the other stream you can take is what we call optional stream one, in which you can go for an ACCA diploma. You do that by writing two other exams, one in taxation and one in audit. Okay? What does that get you? Just first of all, the background here is those two exams consists of 88 hours of classroom work and cost 5,500 zlotys for the tuition fees. It means you need to pass exams in F6 and F8, taxation and audit, and rewrite an external exam in F9. That's a mistake. My apologies in the slide. So just ignore that. Don't worry about that. What you also have to do is join ACCA. But the good news there is there's a very generous discount rate for the fees, and it makes it very financially attractive. In return, you can obtain a diploma granted directly by ACCA. So you've stepped up from a diploma granted by a Polish institution, and you now have a diploma granted by a global professional body, which is going to be recognized anywhere in the world you go. So that might give you more flexibility if you choose to work overseas. Okay, and I think that's going to be the prime motive for people that go that route. The other thing about going this route of the option number one, it can be your stepping stone if you're going to go all the way, and it's your stepping stone to going to the full qualification. Full qualification for ACCA requires you to write some pretty rigorous, what they call professional level papers, but on the other side of those papers is a full qualification to be an ACCA professional accountant, and you've joined an illustrious body, and that's this option one, it becomes your stepping stone to do that. Okay, let's look at the other route. I might have the core program underneath my belt, but I may be working in a shared service center. And ACCA has launched a very exciting new product, new learning tool called the Advanced Certificate in GBS, Global Business Services. That's a very rich and well-designed tool in the market, and my colleague from ACCA, Tomek, is going to debrief you on that in a few minutes. Okay. And after I get off the air. Now the challenge. That's a pretty difficult slide for you to see. I pulled that off the ACCA website. Apologies to those who are out there. And by the way, this whole presentation will be posted on the website, so maybe you can see the small print a little bit more easily. Take a look at those numbers there. And one way to look at the ACCA program, I look at the analogy I have, is it's like crossing a river. And the dangerous part of crossing the river is in the middle. Okay, at the beginning of the ACCA journey, the first level courses, the F1 to F4, most students can handle those because they're designed to ease people into the subject. On the other side of the middle area of the deep water are the professional level courses. Although they're very demanding, in general, they don't stop people from getting through to their ACCA because they've gone so far. And they've already developed the momentum. They know what they're interested in, and they can specialize. The deep water for most people are those five courses from F5, F6, F7, F8, and F9 in the middle, what I call deep water. It's very easy to fail those courses, to fail them repeatedly, and get discouraged, and end up abandoning your journey. And so this is why a program like ours can get you across the water and be useful. Just to give you an example, on my F9 management, financial management, the five-year average global pass rate, if I've calculated correctly on my calculator, is 42%. 42% get through, 48% fail. Okay, so this is a real challenge. It's important that everybody, both ourselves and the participants, the delegates in the program, are appreciative of that. Now, from Lydia, I'm going to stop here because I'm going to try and answer questions as they come at me. Is it possible to make only ACCA diploma without WUTBS diploma? Good question. Actually, it's not possible. You're going to pass through the WUTBS diploma and get it. Okay, and then your optional stream is the question is where to take you further down the road by doing F6 and F8. So then on top of the WUTBS diploma, you're going to have an ACCA diploma. So Lydia, you're going to have two diplomas on your wall if you want to put them there. But I'm sorry, we have to give you one of our diplomas from the Warsaw University of Technology Business School. It's just the stepping stone in the journey. In other words, we can't shortcut it. We can't shortcut it. Part of the reason there is because those three courses, F5, F7, and F9, are really so integral to accounting knowledge that it's hard to imagine calling yourself a professional accountant without having strong base of know-how in management accounting, financial reporting, and financial management. Whereas tax and audit, arguably, those are kind of optional things, but icing on the cake, so to speak. But F5, F7, and F9 really are core. They're foundational courses that people want to get through. They're the building blocks for other things down the road. Thank you for that question. So our motto is, yes, you can, yes, we can. Okay, and this brings us to the point of pass assurance, because somebody should be challenging us out there, and they say, Bob, If 42% is the global average, why can you folks do better? And that's a very question. And I would certainly be asking it if I was in your shoes, okay? We talk about pass assurance. We have a pass assurance section on the website, which gives you more details. But let me summarize why we think we can get you to what our target will be is 85%. Our official pass rate target is going to be 85%. That's our benchmark. If we get less than 85%, we're not doing something right, and we're going to do something to fix it. If we can get more than 85%, we're going to feel pretty good about ourselves. Okay. One is selective admission standards. We do not want to let anybody into the program. We want to make sure that you're well positioned, and I'll talk about this later about the qualifications, that you can do this program. This is not going to be mission impossible for the right people. If we can find the right people, you're going to be comfortable working with us. Okay. Bilingual instruction and testing. The final exam will be in English. Okay. It'll be a 3-hour exam. There'll be a test in English. Okay. But two of your tests will be in Polish. And initially, we're going to start our lectures in the Polish language and have the ability throughout the whole course to speak in both languages, especially when you're coaching. So you might have a detail or stuck on something. And I certainly appreciate this as somebody who's been living in Poland for 20 years. You want to go in your native tongue to sort out the complexities. We have the ability to do that because all our people speak Polish and English quite fluently. I don't speak Polish, but my partner, Mark Galanter, is very fluent in Polish because he's Pole. Okay. The other thing we're doing is we're going to, it's not an all or nothing, an all or nothing situation to pass each course. You're going to have three exams that are worth 15% each. Okay. You're going to write them at the end of the 2 days, and we're going to mark them right away. So you're going to know right away whether you've dropped the ball and where you need to pick up your socks next time around. And then the exam is going to be worth 55% of the final grade. The passing grade is 50% for the whole all papers combined. And so we've got some diversification here. Not all your eggs are in one basket, and you're getting very quick feedback after each test. So there's going to be no surprises, okay, at the end. We're going to offer rewrite opportunities. If somebody, unfortunately, doesn't quite pass an exam or pass at the minimum 50%, they can rewrite the exam again, okay, and they can do it fairly quickly. We're going to have coaching and focusing on where they went wrong, okay, and that'll allow you to get through a second time or through. The exam, of course, will be different. It'll have different numbers. That would make sense to give you the same exam, but it'll have the same topic covered. So you're going to be comfortable with the material. You're going to see different numbers, and you're going to conquer it second time around. At worst, and this could happen, okay, this could happen, let's face it, you may not even get through the rewrite. Hope not, okay, but it could happen. Well, we're not going to push the panic button. You're just going to come back and join us next year for the paper you missed. Get in on the next year's class for free, okay, and at no cost to you. It's going to cost you a little bit of your time, but you can write it again. You may not even sit in the class. You may choose to simply rewrite the exam again. And study at home. So I think that's another what we can call a kick in the cat at the cat. You can do that twice because you've got rewrite privileges. We're going to have the capacity for individual coaching. We're going to be marking your papers very quickly. We're going to be seeing where your knowledge gaps lie, and we're going to zero in on those and deal with those by giving you specific assignments and talking to you directly. So this is not going to be a program where it's anonymous. When we mark the exams, we'll know who John Kowalski is, and we'll be able to talk to him, unlike, let's say, our MBA course where everything is anonymous. We just mark by numbers. This is just a different program. We need to know you. We need to work with you, and so we can walk you through the journey. We're going to be using really, we think, proven study material. It's BPP. There's a lot of material out there, different choices, but we like BPP. We've looked at all the material. In the case of F9, we'll be using a textbook I've written. Hopefully, I think you'll think it's pretty good. Time will tell on that. The one advantage of that textbook, it's co-authored by a colleague of me, myself and another teacher at UMCS, is we have a Polish version and an English version. So you'll be able to read the text and study text in Polish and English. Okay. And finally, and I hope we're not bragging here, but we think we've got a pretty good teaching team. Okay. Here they are here. What you'll see there, and there's some people that are not there, that the coach is not there, that person is coming, hopefully a lady. We've got three ACCAs, okay? Derek, Valdemar, and Jagos, two of them are actually FCAs. So they're ACCAs who have done a lot of teaching on exam preparation in the past. As I mentioned before, I'm a Canadian CA. I article with Pricewaterhouse. And I think a Canadian CA is okay. One exception that breaks a rule about practitioners is Bartomai Nita. He is a teacher at University of Wrocław. He teaches also at our school. He is just too good a management accounting instructor to pass up, so we asked him to join the team. He is an academic, but he does a lot of work in the private sector in his capacity as a consultant. I think you'll enjoy working with him. I know you will. Last time we had the open day, three of our instructors got up and just shared their thoughts with you. We haven't got them here with us today. Let me just tell you briefly about financial management. Mark and I are going to team teach it. Mark has a lot of extensive history and work experience in the global field as a senior executive in manufacturing and the chemical industry. And so he'll be working with me to co-teach this. Financial management, I think, is an interesting subject because it's about making decisions. It's not a compliance thing, what I call a hygiene factor. And our syllabus, like financial management, like all the syllabuses, are very closely tracking the ACCA syllabuses and the ACCA exams. That's why we got the exemption. To earn the exemption, they looked at our exams, they looked at our syllabus. We're allowed a little wiggle room. If I can give you an example of what I'm talking about, the ACCA's version of F9 contains some of the syllabuses on Islamic finance. We've chosen, with ACCA's permission, to drop that topic. We just don't think it's relevant in Poland, so we want to concentrate in other things. And that's just an example of how we can fine-tune our syllabus to match local market conditions. Having said that, our F9, like our F7 and F5, closely tracks, you can tick the boxes, the actual ACCA, official ACCA syllabus. That's what we're here to do. That's why they give us exemptions when you pass our exams. Okay, sorry, I missed that. The know-how applied, this might surprise some of you, is actually business economics. So there's a lot of accounting involved in financial management, but it's a rich subject. You're even seeing human psychology and law and government regulations. But basically, it's applied business economics, a cost-benefit analysis of managing your balance sheet. Okay. Now, the sequence is there. The F9 course is the foundation for those people ambitious and interested enough to move on to the optional stream in the professional level papers. It's called Advanced Financial Management, the P4. There's a textbook there. That textbook was specifically written to be ACCA compliant, and it follows all the topics in the syllabus exactly as you'd find them in the syllabus. It was purpose written for ACCA exam preparation. That's an old slide, that's a duplication slide, you've seen that before. Now, I'm going to call upon my colleague. No other questions. If anyone has questions, please fire them away. Maybe you're leaving them till the end, that's great. I'm going to call on Tomasz to tell us about their new ACCA GBS, an exciting new product. Tomasz, it's all yours.
Dzień dobry Państwu. Bardzo dziękuję Robertowi za zaproszenie. Muszę powiedzieć, że Szkoła Biznesu Politechniki Warszawskiej podjęła wyzwanie i weszła w taką rolę pioniera w myśleniu o tym, jak wygląda współczesny rynek pracy. I stąd mam dzisiaj ogromną przyjemność powiedzieć o drugiej możliwości, jaką mają Państwo w ramach tego programu studiów, drugiej specjalizacji. Zacznę jednak od tego, co mówiła moja poprzedniczka, Patrycja Rokicka. Ponad 7 tysięcy akredytowanych pracodawców ACCA na całym świecie. Jeżeli przyjrzymy się, jacy to są pracodawcy, oprócz tego, że to są najlepsi pracodawcy, najwięksi pracodawcy, ci, którzy prawdopodobnie zapewniają najlepsze warunki rozwoju, jest to weryfikowane przez ACCA, to blisko 40% z nich reprezentuje sektor wspólnych usług finansowych. GBS rozumiany bardzo szeroko, ale w tym momencie mam tu na myśli centra usług finansowych, shared serwisy, które w Polsce, Polska jest trzecim rynkiem na świecie, ponad 200 tysięcy osób w tym sektorze. Warszawa jest drugim takim ogniskiem, drugim takim miejscem w Polsce, gdzie możemy znaleźć najwięcej najlepszych pracodawców w tym sektorze. Stąd nasze myślenie o tych studiach poszło też w tym kierunku, aby zapewnić Państwu możliwość wyboru, dokonania wyboru między ścieżką pierwszą a drugą. Ta druga daje możliwość zdobycia zdania egzaminów i zdobycia kwalifikacji Advanced Diploma in Global Business Services, czyli kwalifikacji dedykowanej temu sektorowi. I chciałbym troszkę więcej teraz o tym opowiedzieć. Przede wszystkim, jeżeli spojrzymy wstecz 10-15 lat do tyłu, to większość z nas skojarzy Centrum Usług Finansowych jako miejsce, w którym siedzą setki, jak nie tysiące osób, które wklepują faktury. Chciałbym Państwu powiedzieć, dla tych z Państwa, którzy nie macie bezpośrednio do czynienia jeszcze z tym sektorem, że już to tak nie wygląda. Jest to miejsce pracy zupełnie się zmieniło. Uległo centralizacji, robotyzacji. Gro pracowników zajmuje się zarządzaniem ludźmi, kreatywną pracą, która ma realizować KPI-e, ale nie tylko te finansowe, ale tak naprawdę cele biznesowe dla całej organizacji. A więc praca w shared serwisie stała się lub staje się jeszcze bardziej kreatywna, ciekawa, bardzo dobrze opłacana. Warszawa jest takim specyficznym, ogromnym, drugim po Krakowie rynkiem, gdzie znajdziemy takich pracodawców jak Coca-Cola, Citibank Handlowy, Pandora, Stanley Black & Decker czy Accenture, można by było jeszcze długo wymieniać. Natomiast to, co jest punktem wspólnym dla tego sektora, to challenge, to wyzwanie, czy też problem związany głównie z zarządzaniem ludźmi, znalezieniem talentów, znalezieniem osób, które będą chciały wchodzić w bardziej odpowiedzialne, zarządcze role, których powstaje coraz więcej i z racji robotyzacji, komputeryzacji procesów finansowych coraz więcej takich osób jest poszukiwanych nagminnie i coraz więcej takich telefonów moja organizacja odbiera codziennie od firm, które poszukują pracowników przygotowanych do pracy w tym sektorze z kompetencjami reprezentujących wiedzę i umiejętności odpowiadające standardom światowym, takim, które na świecie wyznacza ACCA jako wiodąca organizacja w tym zakresie. To, co widać na tym slajdzie, już, jeżeli Państwo już przeczytali, to trudno, ale chciałem zwrócić uwagę na ten obszar związany właśnie z poszukiwaniem talentów i osób, które chcą rozwijać się w tym sektorze i chcą rozwijać organizacje w tym sektorze. To jest ogromne wyzwanie, chyba największe teraz wyzwanie w Polsce. Mimo to w Warszawie wkrótce pojawi się JP Morgan z 3000 miejsc pracy, z czego mogę tylko zgadywać, 1/3 to będą właśnie miejsca pracy w obszarze finansów, czy na przykład największa kancelaria na świecie i bardziej znana Dentons, która niedawno otworzyła swoje Centrum Usług Finansowych w Warszawie. Tak więc tutaj w tym obszarze wyzwania dla pracodawców rosną, a poszukiwanie najlepszych kandydatów staje się coraz większym wyzwaniem. Dlatego też organizacja globalnie na świecie, ale też myśląc o Polsce, rozwinęła półtora roku temu, stworzyła od podstaw kwalifikacje GBS. Jest to nic innego jak inna droga do pełnej kwalifikacji ACC. To inna kwalifikacja. Nie jest to coś, co stoi zupełnie z boku, co jest oderwane od rzeczywistości, jak ma to miejsce w przypadku podobnych kwalifikacji czy też studiów dostępnych na rynku. Jest to kwalifikacja stworzona z pracodawcami od podstaw, odpowiadając na ich potrzeby. Składa się z takiej części, którą dziś będziemy nazywać certyfikatem. Certyfikat ma charakter online'owy, jest e-learningiem, który pozwoli Państwu dokładnie zrozumieć, jak funkcjonuje organizacja typu shared service, jaka jest rola pracownika, jakie są KPI-e, jak łączą się wszystkie procesy. To daje ogromny wgląd w rozumienie tego sektora, nawet osobom, które już pracują w tym sektorze od kilku lat. Bardzo wielu pracodawców wybiera tą certyfikację nawet dla swoich menadżerów obecnie. Natomiast jest ona też doskonałym narzędziem onboardingu, wejścia w ten sektor. Z drugiej strony składa się też z prawdziwych, realnych egzaminów ACCA, które kończą się możliwością uzyskania dyplomu. Czyli jest to nowa, możliwa ścieżka do członkostwa w ACCA, która kończy się dyplomem, jest absolutnie dostosowana do potrzeb osób, które chcą się rozwijać w sektorze usług finansowych. To, co powiedziałem przed chwilą, taki pierwszy entry point, czyli pierwsza możliwość rozpoczęcia tej kwalifikacji, to jest certyfikat. To, co jest przygotowane dla Państwa poprzez Szkołę Biznesu Politechniki Warszawskiej, to ten poziom najbardziej zaawansowany, czyli certyfikat oraz egzaminy F5, F7 i F9. Ta kwalifikacja została stworzona, biorąc pod uwagę, że mają Państwo zwolnienia z egzaminów F1, F2, F3. Najczęściej po ukończeniu studiów na kierunkach finansowych mają Państwo zwolnienia od F1, F4, więc tutaj problemu nie powinno być i można rozpocząć kwalifikację Advanced Diploma. Składa się ona, tak jak wcześniej powiedziałem, z certyfikatu, który ma taki charakter onboardingowy dla Państwa, żeby naprawdę zrozumieć, na czym polega funkcjonowanie tej organizacji, oraz tych egzaminów F5, F7 i F9, oraz prawdziwego ACCA-owego, mówiąc już tak bardzo prosto, modułu etycznego, takiego samego, który jest wymagany przy uzyskaniu członkostwa w naszej organizacji. To razem daje możliwość Państwu uzyskania dyplomu. Nie będę przechodził szczegółowo przez sylabus, który jest przypisany do tej części certyfikatu i e-learningowej. Mogą Państwo tylko tak, nawet lecąc wzrokiem przez ten slajd, zauważyć, że jest to szeroki zakres. Także patrzymy tutaj jednak na organizację z punktu widzenia GBS, czyli takiej organizacji, która łączy różne procesy z różnych obszarów, nie tylko finansowe. Natomiast nie skupiamy się na tych obszarach pozafinansowych bardzo szczegółowo, bo nie są one przedmiotem tej kwalifikacji kluczowe, natomiast potrzebne jest rozumienie, w jakim stopniu część finansowa jest połączona z innymi działami firmy. Advanced Diploma to oprócz e-learningu, tych modułów certyfikatu, to prawdziwe egzaminy F5, F7, F9 oraz moduł etyczny. I tutaj ten sylabus w takim dużym skrócie mają Państwo dostępny w tej prezentacji do dalszego wykorzystania. Podsumowując, ta kwalifikacja na tej uczelni jest pierwszym tego typu projektem na pewno w Europie i na ponad 100% w Polsce, jest projektem pionierskim. Dlaczego? Dlatego, że gdyby Państwo chcieli zdobyć tą kwalifikację indywidualnie, to nie ma takiej możliwości. Jest to kwalifikacja stworzona do współpracy organizacji ACCA z pracodawcami, a więc stroną, która zawiera umowę, która umożliwia studentom podjęcie tej kwalifikacji, jest pracodawca, jest firma, jest organizacja. Politechnika Warszawska jako pierwsza w Polsce podjęła to wyzwanie i ten trud, żeby umożliwić Państwu rozpoczęcie tej kwalifikacji poprzez uczelnię, a nie poprzez pracodawcę. Tak więc w ramach opłaty tutaj związanej z tymi studiami mają Państwo zapewnione przy tej kwalifikacji wszystkie opłaty ACCA. To jest opłata rejestracyjna, opłata roczna, opłata za zwolnienia z egzaminów, które Państwo wykorzystają przy tej kwalifikacji. Natomiast jedynym zaskoczeniem może dla Państwa będzie, ale dla mnie rzeczą oczywistą, że przy tej kwalifikacji, jak przy każdym dyplomie ACCA, trzeba zdać przynajmniej jeden prawdziwy egzamin. W przypadku Advanced Diploma in Global Business and Services to jest egzamin F9. Czyli mają Państwo, studiując w Szkole Biznesu Politechniki Warszawskiej, zwolnienia z tych trzech egzaminów, dlatego że wchodzą Państwo przez program i podchodzą do egzaminów w trakcie studiów. Natomiast należy zdać tutaj prawdziwy egzamin F9, natomiast zarówno kwestia wszystkich kosztów związanych z przystąpieniem do organizacji, jak i sam koszt zapisu na egzamin jest pokryty już tutaj przez uczelnię. Tak więc nie muszą się Państwo w ogóle martwić o kwestie kosztowe dodatkowe w relacji z naszą organizacją, z ACCA. Myślę, że to jest tyle w dużym skrócie z mojej strony. I tutaj widzę pytanie od Lidii. Mam nadzieję, że to jest pytanie do mnie, że ono nie było wcześniej. Is it possible to make only ACCA diploma without... Chyba odpowiedziałem na to pytanie w takim sensie, że Politechnika Warszawska pioniersko daje Państwu możliwość rozpoczęcia kwalifikacji GBS poprzez Politechnikę Warszawską. Indywidualnie nie jest to możliwe i studiowanie na Politechnice daje Państwu możliwość skorzystania z zwolnień z egzaminów F5, i F7. Tak więc zostaje tylko jeden egzamin do zdania, F9. Wydaje mi się, że to ma największy sens, zarówno kosztowo, jak i patrząc na wysiłek, jaki należałoby podjąć, podejmując tą ścieżkę samemu, korzystając potencjalnie ze szkoleń zewnętrznych, które przy tych już trudniejszych egzaminach, które są egzaminami typu skills, a więc oparte w dużej mierze na case'ach, na trudnych wyzwaniach, zadaniach, które trzeba rozwiązywać, udowadniać swój sposób myślenia, nie tylko liczenia. Tutaj Państwo mają zapewnione pełne przygotowanie do tych egzaminów. Podchodzą Państwo do tych egzaminów w trakcie studiów, mają Państwo pewność, że te egzaminy są zdane i te zwolnienia są prawdziwe i że są Państwo gotowi do podjęcia ścieżki professional i dojścia do członkostwa w ACCA, więc absolutnie rekomenduję skorzystanie z tej jedynej w Polsce okazji. Tyle chyba wydaje mi się już w tym temacie. Czy są jakieś inne pytania w kwestii tylko tej ścieżki GBS-owej? Nie widzę na razie. Rozumiem, że przekazuję głos kierownikowi projektu. Dziękuję bardzo.
Thank you, Tomasz. Dziękuję bardzo. The thing that we find exciting about GBS is we work closely with the ABSL, Association of Business Service Leaders. One of their board members is a graduate of our university. And they tell us that the shared service centers is now the largest industry, single industry in Poland. And Poland has become very good at this sector. I was speaking with a large global firm and the second largest shared service center in the whole global firm. They operate in 120 countries, is in Poland. This is a special talent that Poles seem to have. So this GBS certificate is, we hope, going to really hit the spot. And Tomek mentioned the news about JP Morgan Chase coming to Warsaw from London. That's also very good news indeed. You missed that slide, Tomek. You need to do that?
Or do I, no,
I keep pressing on? Well, we're open for questions and answers, but we're also pushing about an hour on the clock. We don't want to keep you here all night. And I'll see if there's any more questions. Oh, I've got one from Alexander. Why should I sign up and sacrifice weekends and studying on my own and just write exam questions online? That's a good question. That's a very good question. That goes to the heart of it. Alexander, first of all, he's right. ACCA cycles, we have open ACCA courses, exam sessions four times a year. They're being held at the British Council here in Warsaw. You can purchase materials from any of the educational suppliers, BPP and others. You can take courses online as well, and you don't need to be in the classroom. I guess the answer to that is twofold, to Alexander. One, it's proven just how difficult it is to be on your own. Even a dedicated person who's fully dedicated to the cause of passing will find it challenging to be on their own in isolation, working in isolation, without the give and take of the classroom, without being able to bounce ideas off of other colleagues. Working on their own with the distractions every day, the distractions of family and work surrounding them. You walk in here on a Friday, you'll turn your cell phones off, they won't be allowed to be on, and you'll walk in at 9 and you'll leave at 5 o'clock at night, and it'll be, believe me, a very intensive, very concentrated learning experience for 2 days in a row. That's one reason, okay? And Alexander, the other reason is you could study on your own and pass individual exams, and maybe, if you're good and worked hard, get through them all. Then again, you might not get through them all. And what you're left with is some credits from ACCA having passed these exams, which of course you can put on your CV, okay? What you can get working through our program is if you can get through at least those three exams, which form the foundation of anybody who wants to call themselves a finance and accountancy professional, is you get a degree from a Polish university. And we think that's worth something. And that, I think, will show well in your CV. So I hope that's answered your question there. Just by way of summary, some more questions might come in. The website's there for everybody to see. We're working on it. We're just launching, so please work with us. We might have some issues in it, but we're going to fix it as soon as possible. Anna is asking me a question. Does the school provide learning materials? Are there costs included in the course fee? Anna, they are, yes. So you get the BPP learning materials in the case of F5 and F7. And in the case of F9, you get the learning materials my book in both Polish and English. The book is 400 pages in length in Polish and English. So you could use it as a doorstopper that tells you also something about the content. So the answer is yes. Okay. Also, you get from us, apart from learning materials, a textbook that you'll study at home. There'll be lots of supplemental learning materials, quick tests that we'll do, practice tests. We'll have a lot to keep you busy and practice on. Very important part of the learning process. Practice makes perfect, as we say in English. Practice makes perfect. Okay. The registration process is web-based. Hopefully we've got all the wrinkles ironed out. It's on the website. There's a four-step process that you go. The website takes you through it. Okay. Our admission criteria is, I think, quite sensible and makes sense for both of us, both the school and you people. Here's what we need from you. Okay. You need, at the very least, a university degree, either an undergraduate or graduate degree in a related field. By related field, it's related to accounting and finance. So that would include economics, business, accounting, finance, anything in the close to surrounding the economics field. And it can be undergraduate or graduate. Okay. Basically, if you have that, we have faith that giving you exemptions in F1 to F4 makes a lot of sense. You'll cover that know-how in your existing university degree. Okay. But you might not have a degree in a related field. Maybe you've got a degree in psychology or a degree in art history, but you've got 4 to 5 years relevant work experience in the field doing accounting and finance work, maybe at a shared service center. So you've established your bona fides by doing on-the-job work, and that can make up for not having a degree in a related field. And finally, you need to make sure you have English language proficiency. We are going to be able to speak in Polish, but this is ACCA, and the thing that makes ACCA powerful is not only have a high standard of technical knowledge and professional knowledge in the topics, but it's also an English language designation that can take you anywhere in the world that's recognized worldwide. So English language proficiency is important. To test that, we've got an online test in English. It sounds like it's a little ominous, but it's not. It's 100 questions sprinkled out through general business knowledge, also some knowledge in management accounting, financial reporting, and financial management. You've got 90 minutes to answer those. You'll get the score immediately. And what we're looking for there is at least 50%. At least 50%, less than 50%, there should be some real doubts in your own mind, because the test is not that hard, whether you want to embark on this program. Ideally, if you've got over 60%, you're in automatically. Between 50 and 60%, we'd have a chat with you and just explore with you whether you're going to be fully comfortable taking the course. Okay. So language proficiency is necessary. You don't have to be a Shakespeare. You just need to understand and communicate and write that exam in English. That's the key point there. I've got another question from Alexander. He's curious, is it possible to pay the course fee in installments? And the answer is yes. Alex, the course fee for the core course is $10,500, and as described on the website, it's paid in three installments. The first installment is one-third, and it's before you register, and the second installments are later on into the year. And also a reminder that we have the finance program set up by Citibank and Bovi to help you out on the financial side. This slide just tells you about the deadlines. We want to launch. Our first course is 8th of December. We want to close the recruitment at the end of October. So if you're on the edge and thinking about it, please think about it hard and sign up by October 30th. And that's also the deadline for the first installment. We hope that makes sense, because we've got to get on with it and get going and get everybody prepared. There will also be some preparatory work before we start the first weekend, but that's a detail. Okay. And finally, accounting and finance, that's the address at the website. Also, please feel free to reach out to me. Either my address is patterson@ikp.pl. IKP could stand for I Keep Promises. I'll answer your questions, or you can simply send an email query to the school, and it will find it to be dealt with by the administration office or myself. So that's it. We're looking at 7 o'clock. I'm quite happy, and Tomek and I are quite happy to stay and answer any questions, but we don't want to keep you too long. So if we don't see any more questions coming through, that may be a sign that we've explained everything. Let me just wrap up with one little question that if I was in your shoes, I might ask. I certainly would ask, or at least I would think this might be going through your mind. I would say to the school, why, when I've got a job and I'm gainfully employed and the job market is pretty pretty favorable to staff and employees, okay, it's a tight market in fact, why would I pay $10,500? I could buy a car for that, a second-hand car, but $10,500 is $10,500. But more importantly, sacrifice 12 weekends in a busy lifetime and put a pretty big hole in my year in 2017 and 2018 to get this qualification from ACCA accredited qualification from the Warsaw University of Technology. That would be my question if I was, I think, in your shoes. And is there an answer to that? Well, I guess one answer is if you're ambitious and you want to get ahead and you're curious, that could be one answer. But maybe you know the subject already. And here's the seed I would like to plant for you. And I take it off a phrase that Warren Buffett uses. And he says, it's when the tide goes out, you find out who's swimming naked. When the tide goes out, you find out who's swimming naked. Of course, and the term naked is when you don't have you have an unhedged position in your investments. And what he's driving at there, of course, is when times are tough is the real test of people. We are definitely in a robust market right now, and Poland is enjoying a great ride. The stock market is up, okay? But your horizon is going to be a lot longer than next year or the year after, or even a lot longer than 5 years. You want to get a career track building and launched and get some momentum build up and to take you through to your retirement. And believe me, I'm 66, and it'll flash by in a flash. So that would be my answer. My answer is somebody was in your shoes and questioning why I'd make that sacrifice. The answer is I think it's an investment. Gabriella, all Friday days will be taken. We're going to get, not all Fridays in that 7-8 month period. There'll be some gaps in between to catch your breath. Between the 2 day weekends, you'll also be needing to prepare and digest what you've learned. We've chosen Friday, by the way, and I'm repeating myself here. The other option for a part-time course would be Saturday and Sunday. That would, however, require you to write off a lot of your Sundays, and we just think, in our judgment and doing the research we've done and talking to employers and staff, that that would be mission impossible. This is a demanding mission, a demanding journey you're staying out on. So it is all day Friday. That means you've got to go to your employer and negotiate time off. And either you'll get time off leave of absence because you're doing a study leave, or maybe you take holiday period for that day. The employers and staff we've spoken to are generally sympathetic to that because they see that there's value in somebody doing this. If they're not sympathetic, you may want to ask yourself, you know, what's why not, and whether that's a good sign. But that's between you and your employer. Are there any other questions out there? Okay, well, I'm not going to sit here all night, and nor are you. This is my first webinar. I hope I've done all right. It's kind of interesting when you don't have live faces in front of you. If there are no other questions, let us just say thank you for sharing your time with us. And thank you for considering this program. We're excited about it. We're going to get it right. We think we've got a good plan and a plan of action. Past assurance is something that's very important to us. But we're always open and looking for feedback and ideas. So please, if you think I've said something, or Tomek and I and Patricia have said something that doesn't make sense from you, from your point of view, or doesn't fit your needs, please let us hear about it. We'd like to hear, okay? This program is a demand-driven program, okay? The customer, I think it's an old phrase, you're not customers,
you're not students, we're calling you participants. That's a subtle difference because your past your student days, you're a different kettle of fish. Anna, thank you for thanking us, and we thank you. So goodbye for now. Thank you very much, and please stay in touch. We hope you enjoy the webinar. Bye for now. Cheers. Do widzenia.